This is the PS Vita, folks, or as I personally like to call it, one of the last remaining bastions that Android emulation has yet to conquer. Or has it? That's what we're gonna find out today. You see, my dear nerds, I took it upon myself to find out whether or not Vita games have a place in our emulation collections. In our archive of ROMs, that we legally own, of course. Wink, wink. Whether or not they are deserving of sitting there alongside our favorite games. Considering that you clicked on this video, I suppose that you know what the PS Vita is by now. I'm not gonna insult your intelligence by dragging you out for 2 minutes explaining very basic things. We know that the PS Vita is the successor of the PSP, which we can emulate perfectly on Android right now. In fact, I would dare say that there's no other handheld or retro console that has better supported emulation as of now than the original PSP. So why don't we have this for the PS Vita? I kept asking myself. Because we do have an emulator. There's an emulator called Vita3K, which has an Android version which supposedly is fairly good at emulating Vita games on Android. At least, if I am to go by their compatibility list, which shows almost 2/3 of all released games as playable. So I took it upon myself to see what's up. Know that Vita3K as an emulator has been around for several years, it's just that it hasn't been as talked about as all the others. And I dove very deep into it, and I have to tell you straight off the bat, Vita3K is weird. It's really weird. It's the black sheep of emulators, and I'm choosing my words very carefully here. It behaves unlike any other emulator out there. Let me explain. You see, my dear nerds, Vita3K doesn't actually launch ROMs. You can't just plop your Vita games in a folder, point the emulator to that folder, and presto, you have a working configuration there. It takes some head scratching to set all of this up, so I'm gonna walk you through it so that you get to play by yourself with the games that you legally own. No, seriously, don't get me into trouble. I hope you do own the games that you try. If not, you're a grown boy or girl. I'm not responsible for what you do. But enough chit-chatting. Let me actually show you around the emulator, because that's why you're here. That's why you're spending your life's seconds listening to me right now. I might as well give you some value, so have some value. Basically, once you install the emulator, you pick a language, blah blah blah, and then you have to download and install 2 firmware files directly from Sony, which I'm convinced that Sony made them available especially for this use case. So, you have to download these 2 firmware files, the firmware file itself and the font package, and then you have to point the emulator back to them so that the emulator installs them within the emulator itself. Note that this is important, we will see a lot of this moving forward, with each new thing that we install, being firmware packages or games. We are installing them inside the emulator itself, meaning that the emulator size keeps growing. But I'll touch upon this later in the video. For now, let's move forward. So you install these 2 files, and then supposedly you're done with the initial configuration of the emulator. But bear in mind that the graphical user interface of this emulator is, oh god, how should I put this? Rough. I mean, I know what they're trying to do. They're trying to present a very bare bones version of how the Vita OS feels and acts like, but it's downright unpolished and rough. But it doesn't matter, Vita3K is still a work in progress, even though it's been released for quite some time. I refuse to think of this emulator as something that's supposedly finished and polished. I just can't say this. I think that Vita3K still needs a lot of work, so keep that in mind as we move forward. Now you have to procure your games. I'm not allowed to tell you where to get them. I'm allowed to tell you that you should rip them from your own sources or CDs. There definitely aren't websites out there which allow you to download Vita games fairly easily. And you definitely can't find these sources on Reddit, so don't go looking for them there. But in case you're one of those evil pirates that downloads stuff on the internet which they can't legally buy nowadays, well, first of all, Jesus would be disappointed in you. And legally speaking, I'm obligated to say the same. But no matter how you got your hands on some Vita games, let's move on. You see, my dear nerds, most probably your Vita games will be packaged as something that you can't currently use. If your games are anything other than a zip file or a PKG file, what you actually have to do now is sort of a head scratcher. Most probably you procured your games as a 7-zip file. You have to enter that archive, reach the folder that is actually the game itself. It may start with PC, E, whatever. Then you have a bunch of numbers until you have a folder name similar to this. And you have to copy that out of the archive or extract from the archive. And then you have to re-archive that specific folder as a zip file. You can do this directly on your Android device, or you can do this via a laptop. That's up to you. I'm not gonna hold your hands on this. If you have more questions about this process, ask me in the comments. The awesome nerd community that we have around this channel will probably help you out. So now, technically, you should have a zip file of your game, which, congrats, it means that most of the stuff is done. Now you only have to go to File, and you have to install the zip that we just created. So now you click File on the top left corner, and then you click Install Zip File or something similar. I'm trying to remember because I'm saying this off the top of my head. And your game should install. Congrats, you have your first Vita game on your Android device. But we are not done. It's your fault if you think we're done. Because we are not done, just like in life. When you think you're done with something, you have to put another 300% of the equivalent labor that you put up until that point. That's how soul-crushing emulating Vita is, and that's how soul-crushing life is. It's your fault for thinking differently. If I was to talk, just know that I love you. It's out of love. I swear, it's called tough nerd love, I swear, it comes from the heart. In any case, now we should try your game. Maybe it works, maybe it doesn't. With Vita3K, it's sort of like a roulette. You see, you don't know if you're gonna land on playable or broken. For this particular video, I tried two games. I tried Mortal Kombat 9, which was one of my personal favorites ever since I owned an Xbox 360. And Ridge Racer, because I love the PSP version of this game, and in my silly nerd head, I was like, huh, newer generation console must mean a more awesome version of the game. The logic is sound. And this is where I have mixed feelings about everything, because you see, my dear nerds, Mortal Kombat 9 technically ran. I ran it on 1X, which means the default resolution that the PS Vita had, and without adding any custom graphics drivers to the emulator. This is again important for later. And honestly, I kinda liked the experience. I mean, don't get me wrong, we can see that the PS Vita is no spring chicken, the graphics are fairly outdated, we can especially notice this in the textures, which I guess that's fair. The Vita was released more than 10 years ago, that's perfectly excusable. And there were some graphical glitches here and there, some shaders had to compile, there was a bit of stuttering at the beginning, but after 30 seconds or so, the game pretty much ran flawlessly on the Lenovo Legion Y700 with a Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 processor. Actually, take a look for yourself, this is Mortal Kombat 9 running at 1X with the default graphics driver. Not bad, right? A fun fact about this emulator is that custom graphics drivers are interchangeable between what Yuzu, the Nintendo Switch emulator, used to use, and what Vita3K uses. So I tried the Turnip driver that I used in my Yuzu build as well, and it seemed to work a bit better. Here's the same game running at 2x internal resolution, and I can say that this can pass off as an enjoyable experience. But then I tried Ridge Racer, and the results were, how should I put this, torturous. This is what I would imagine all emulators would work as in hell, when we would all inevitably perish because we are doomed with this freaking mortality of our meatbag-like statuses, and when inevitably 99% of us go to hell, we will have emulation performance like this. That's disturbing, isn't it? That was Ridge Racer getting stuck in the menu, even though if we were to go on the Vita3K official compatibility list, this game was marked as playable. Joke's on me, I guess. So then I tried Ridge Racer with the custom GPU graphics driver, and the results were kind of better, kind of worse, in the sense that that horrific menu sound ceased to exist, but now the game would just outright crash once it would hit the main menu. So, in my opinion, we have a 50% success rate with Vita games, which, granted, this is a very small sample size. Most probably a lot of them actually work with a bit of tinkering. But this is not the end of it, because there is one deal-breaking thing about the Vita3K emulator which will personally prevent me from ever using it. And I can't feasibly incorporate it in my collection of thousands and thousands of ROMs that I legally own. And you know why that's the case? Because this mother-flipping emulator can't be incorporated in game frontends, meaning that it can't integrate with neither Daijisho or Beacon Launcher. I will always have to use it as a standalone thing. And this just kills me. I will either have all of my ROMs in one place to trick my brain that I'm running a handheld console of sorts, or I will not run it at all. Vita3K has been around for many years now, and I understand from a technical point of view why this is the case, because games are technically installed inside the emulator itself. In fact, after you install a game, just like we did when we archived the zip file, after that you can actually delete the game assets that you played around in the first place with downloading, archiving into a zip, and so on and so forth, thus freeing some extra space as well. But because the emulator works like this, the biggest side effect is that you are basically stuck inside that sandbox that Vita3K creates. It tries to copy the Vita OS in such a way, in such a faithful way, I would add, that it leans more into giving you a sort of bare bones Vita OS rather than giving you an emulator. It doesn't act like an emulator, it acts like the operating system that you find on a Vita. But unfortunately for me, and I'm convinced many other people that are like-minded, they will not tolerate this, because Vita3K would ideally be just one part of a huge collection of platforms and games which people want centralized in one place. So I'm passing the ball down to you now. Would you use Vita3K? Do you care about Vita emulation or Vita games? Or would you rather just buy a second-hand PS Vita, because this is always an option, and quite frankly, it's not a bad option to begin with. In fact, I have a very good friend that did exactly this, and that friend had a ton of fun with the Vita. He modded the flipping poop out of it, he installed the USB-C on it, he changed the batteries, he put RGB in the shoulder buttons. Needless to say, I'm quite proud of him. Would you go down this route that my friend took, or would you go down the emulation route for the games that you own? Let me know in the comments, I read each and every one of the comments. I might not reply to all of them, but I read them, and I love you for leaving them. And if you love what I do here, consider helping out the channel by becoming either a channel member or a Patreon. Whichever variant you choose, you end up on my wall of fame, which I feature in each and every video, and everyone will know that you support this little channel to grow up. Plus, I will love you forever. I'm not even kidding. And if you want to personally talk with me, I will wait for you in my Discord. I have a very small Discord channel, you can also find me there. But this is all from me now, my sweet nerds. Until next time, I hope you know that I love you. And I'm not just throwing this word around. I love you more than most humans on this planet, but not more than your dog. Remember this. Bye, my sweet nerd. See you in the next clip.